Good morning. Myself, Dr. Smita. I'm assistant professor in the department of ECE RNSIT. Today we'll be discussing on current and conductors. In fact, last few classes you might have come across something like what is electric field intensity, then about potential difference, then something on work and energy. So from there, from that point, now we'll move on to try to know what is current and conductors. So it is, first thing is, what is current and current density? As we know, electric charges in motion constitute a current. Okay, that is as we know, the charges flowing is nothing but it will give you the current, and the unit of current is in amperes, where the current I, it is represented as dq by dt. And now we'll see what is one more term, that is something on current density. Where current density is denoted by J vector, and the unit of current density is ampere per meter square, or ampere into meter power minus 2. And this current density, which is denoted by J vector, it is called as, or we can define it as, current per unit area, wherein that is nothing but current density denoted by J vector. And using this current density, we can find out what is known as current. Instead of defining the current in terms of charges, we can also find out this current through using current density. That is, the incremental current delta I crossing an incremental surface delta S can be represented as delta I equal to J vector dot product with differential surface area vector. So that is what we can see here. This is delta I equal to J vector dot product with differential surface area vector, where this is the incremental current and this is the current density. Unit of current density is ampere per meter square. Multiplying by the area gives you the current. So current, using current density, we can find out the current. The incremental current is current density dot product with differential surface area vector, delta S vector. So from that differential current, using that, you can find out the total current, where the total current I equal to surface integral J dot ds vector, where J is the current density and this is the differential surface area vector. Okay, so by integrating this J vector over the surface area, we can find out the total current over the surface, where total current I, which is in amperes, which will be equal to surface integral J dot ds vector, where these two are vector, and if you take the dot product on these two vector, it results in a scalar. Wherein, let us consider an example. Suppose we have a differential charge, okay, which is in the form of a present, it is in the cuboid. Let us consider a cuboid where it is having the front, the surface area of that is differential surface area delta S, okay. And suppose that cuboid is having a length of differential length, let me call it as delta L, okay. Wherein, if you know differential volume, that is differential volume of this cuboid can be written as this differential surface area multiplied by differential length. That is, this differential volume is differential surface into differential length. By using this, you can find out the differential charge present in this differential volume, where suppose the charge distribution in this volume, if it is equal to nothing but if it is in the form of a volume charge density, denoted by this rho v. Okay, what is the unit of rho v? It is nothing but coulomb per meter cube. Charge per unit volume is nothing but the volume charge density, where knowing volume charge density and the differential volume, we can find out differential charge, where the differential charge dq will be equal to volume charge density multiplied by differential volume. That is, delta q is equal to rho v into delta v. Okay, now knowing this, what we'll do is we'll take an example. Suppose this differential volume, if this differential volume, let us assume it is moving along x direction. Okay, this differential volume is moving along x direction. Okay, over a time interval of delta t, let me take a small time interval, that is differential time delta t. Over a small time differential time delta t, if it moves, this charges moves a differential length delta x. Okay, suppose over a small time delta t, if this charge moves a differential length delta x, that is, if this full volume of charge, it is moving in the direction of x. Okay, so if it takes a length of delta x over a small interval of time delta t, then we'll try to find out what is a differential current, and then we'll try to find out what is total current. Okay, as we know, the charges flowing or the motion of charges will constitute a current. Because of that, what we are taking here is the charges are moving. Here, instead of telling the surface charge, here we have taken it as volume charge. Okay, so this volume charges are moving along x direction, and over a differential length, differential time delta t, if it moves a differential length delta x. Okay, let us find out what is the differential charge crossing this length, differential length delta x, over a time of delta t. So we'll find the differential charge and then the differential current. So we can see here, we have considered what is called the differential element of charge delta q equal to rho v into delta v, right? Then this delta v, that is the differential volume, can be written as differential surface area multiplied by differential length. Okay, that is what it has been shown in this diagram. This is the differential surface and this is the differential length. So multiplying this into this gives you differential volume. Okay, so hence the differential charge can be written as rho v into delta v. It is also same as writing rho v into delta s into delta l. Okay, so suppose in a time interval of delta t, if these element of charges has moved a distance delta x, hence what you can write, over that period of time, what is the delta q crossing that length delta x, can be written as delta q equal to rho v into delta s into delta x. Okay, in fact you can call it as delta q dash. Okay, which are nothing but, these are the charges which are moving in an interval of delta t, which are crossing a length of delta x. Hence the delta q or delta q dash can be written as volume charge density multiplied by the surface area multiplied by the differential length delta x. Okay, hence the differential current is nothing but this charge delta q divided by the length or the differential time delta t. That is, delta I will be equal to delta q by delta t, where delta q is what? That is nothing but, here it is nothing but rho v into delta s into delta x. So that is what, here delta q is rho v into delta s into delta x. So divided by this delta t, that gives you delta I. Okay, that means the current delta I can be redefined as this volume charge density multiplied by the differential surface multiplied by this, the differential length divided by the small interval of time dt. So this dx by dt is nothing but the velocity of charges in x direction. Okay, so that is the differential current is nothing but volume charge density multiplied by the differential surface area, and this ratio is nothing but the velocity of the charges. Here I have taken the charges if they are flowing only in the x direction, let us call it as velocity of the charges, and suffix x is because the charges are moving in x direction. So from this we can find out what is called as current density, okay, because we know current density is nothing but current per unit area. Okay, so we have this current. If you divide this by differential surface, that is delta S, what are we going to get? We'll get it as rho v into velocity vector. Okay, hence the current density is volume charge density multiplied by the velocity. Suppose if you take the velocity in x direction, then it will become the current density will be in the x direction. So where the current density is in the direction of velocity. So in general, we can write it as current density J vector is equal to volume charge density multiplied by the velocity vector. Okay, this type of current density is known as convection current density. Okay, this is actually convection current, and this one is nothing but the convection current density. Okay, I repeat, the current density unit is ampere per meter square. So current here, the convection current density, which is nothing but in terms of volume charge density and the velocity vector, that is J vector equal to rho v into velocity vector. This is called convection current density, and the unit is same thing, ampere per meter square. Now we'll try to understand a new theorem, in fact, that is called as continuity of current. Okay, in fact, this can also be taken when you move on to the time varying fields. Okay, but let me cover this topic here only, that is continuity of current. So consider a region which is a closed surface. Okay, consider a region which is a closed surface. Okay, in this closed surface, suppose there is an outward flow of current. There is an outward flow of current, and this outward flow of current, let me take it as I equal to closed surface integral J dot ds vector, and it is also nothing but surface integral J dot ds vector. Okay, so there is an outward flow of the current in this closed surface, which is nothing but current I equal to surface integral J dot ds vector. Okay, because of this outward flow, okay, there is a decrease in positive charges in the closed surface. Okay, since because of this outward flow of the charges, there is a decrease in positive charges inside. Okay, so what we call it as, we can denote it as, there is a rate of decrease in the charges, which is represented as the rate of decrease is represented by minus dq by dt. Okay, rate of decrease is represented by minus, and there is that current is decreasing, the current is decreasing, the current is represented as dq by dt. Okay, so the rate of decrease of charges inside because of this outward flow of current is represented as minus dq by dt. Okay, wherein, so from this we'll see what you can rewrite or re-express this as. Okay, one thing before attaining to this one, let us recollect of you know about divergence theorem. What the divergence theorem states, the surface integral or the closed surface integral J dot ds can be related in terms of volume integral, that is surface integral J dot ds will be equal to volume integral divergence, that is del dot J is nothing but divergence, okay, divergence of divergence over a differential volume. Okay, so from divergence theorem we know that we can express it as the closed surface integral j dot ds is equal to volume integral divergence of current density over a differential volume. Okay, using this divergence theorem, this right hand side let us keep as it is, that is volume integral divergence of j into dv, okay, which is equal to this LHS can also be written as, surface integral j dot ds is nothing but current. Okay, what is current? Current can be written as minus d by dt of charge. Okay, and what is charge q? Charge q can be written as volume integral rho v into dv. What is rho v? Rho v is volume charge density. Okay, where, so I'm trying to express this surface integral j dot ds as nothing but this one. Okay, where this is nothing but current I, where current I is minus dq by dt. So I've written minus d by dt as it is. This q can be written as volume integral rho v into dv. Okay, so if it is in the form of volume charge density, we can write it as volume integral rho v into dv, where by keeping this surface containing the derivative becomes partial derivative. That means what I'm trying to do here is, see, we can do this integral first and then do the differentiation with respect to time, or you can do this operation first and then do the integral afterwards. Okay, that means this time is independent of this integral. Okay, this is in spatial coordinates and this is with respect to the time. Hence, this time is independent of the spatial coordinate. So you can do this integral first and do this time derivative afterwards, or we can compute the time derivative first and then we can do the spatial integral later. Okay, so by taking this time derivative first, it will become partial derivative. This will become partial derivative. Hence, the left hand side I have kept as it is, volume integral del dot j dv, which is equal to, we are taking the d by dt inside. Now it will become partial derivative, that is volume integral minus dou by dou t of rho v. And we are in, after doing this partial differentiation, then you have to find out the you have to integrate in order to find out the current. Okay, so that is what we have got now, that is volume integral minus dou rho v by dou t into differential volume. Okay, just look at this left hand side with the right hand side equation. What you can analyze from this, both are volume integral. Okay, and this side we have del dot j, here this is nothing but minus dou v by dou t. Okay, so from, by comparing these two, where volume integral over a differential volume, and what we are integrating, that is del dot j. Okay, so from this you can write it as del dot j equal to minus dou rho v by dou t. Okay, so we can write it as del dot j equal to minus dou rho v by dou t. Okay, this equation is known as current continuity equation, or also sometimes it is also called as continuity equation. So this divergence of j, which is equal to minus dou by dou t of volume charge density, this equation is known as current continuity equation. Okay, what is the statement of this? The current diverging from a small volume per unit volume is equal to time rate of decrease of charge per unit volume at every point. Okay, the current what is diverging from the small volume per unit volume, that is this. Okay, that is this, which is equal to time rate of decrease, because here we have minus. Okay, time rate of decrease of this charge per unit volume, because we have a volume charge density at every point. Okay, time rate of decrease of this charge per unit volume, that is nothing but current diverging of small volume per unit volume. So this equation is known as current continuity equation, that is del dot j equal to minus dou rho v by dou t. Okay. Now we'll take few examples based on this, what all we have learned just now, that is current is equal to surface integral j dot ds. Okay. So the first problem is given j vector is equal to 10 rho square z aero cap minus 4 rho cos square phi a phi cap milli ampere per meter square. Okay, the find the first part in this, find the current density at point P with coordinates 3, 30 degree comma 2. Okay, this is in which coordinate system? It is in cylindrical coordinate system. Okay, the problem is in cylindrical coordinate system. Okay, so first let us find out this part A, that is current density at point P. At point P means wherever this rho phi z comes, we just have to substitute. This is rho equal to 3, phi equal to 30 degree and z equal to 2. Okay, so what we are trying to do here is, it is 10 into rho square. Rho is how much? 3. So it is 3 square into z. Z is nothing but, here it is 2. We have substituted that, minus 4 into rho. Rho is nothing but 3 into cos square. What is phi? 30 degree. Cos square 30 degree. So you can calculate this. It's just using calculator. What we are going to get is 180 aero cap minus 9 a phi cap, and the unit is milliamp, the same thing, milliamp per meter square. Okay, because the current density is given is as milliamp per meter square. So j at point P, we are getting it as so much vector, unit is milliamp per meter square. Okay, now we'll move on to the part B. Okay, what is part B? Determine the total current flowing outward through the circular band, rho equal to 3 and phi equal to 0 to 2 pi, and z is varying between 2 to 2.8. Okay. So they have given, there is a constant radius, okay, and phi limit and z limits are mentioned. Okay. So that means what? This is the differential surface area for a constant rho. Okay. It is a differential surface area for a constant rho. So where, that means the differential surface area vector for a constant rho is rho into d phi into dz into aero cap. Okay. So we have to integrate with respect to phi and z, where rho is constant. Okay. So current I will be equal to surface integral j dot ds. What is j? J is this whole vector, but the differential surface is for only constant rho, which is having aero cap. So if you take the dot product of this whole thing, we know aero dot aero is 1. Okay. But if you take aero dot a phi, it is 0. Okay. Hence, you get only this term. So we have to integrate this term, that is the j rho, j rho component with respect to the differential surface area for a constant rho. So it becomes this 10 rho square into z multiplied by this area rho d phi dz. So what it becomes? 10 rho square into this rho. Okay. So it becomes 10 rho cube z into d phi into dz. Okay. And since milli is there, let us write it in standard unit, hence it is written as into 10 power minus 3. Okay, so that means it may be in ampere per meter square. And now it is all just a integration, rho cube integration. Rho cube is constant, but z we have to integrate, so it will become z square by 2. Limit is from we have here 2 to 2.8, and d phi integration is phi, and the limit is 0 to 2 pi, just substituting this limit, the answer will be equal to 3.26 amperes. Okay. So we are trying to find the current, which is nothing but surface integral J dot ds. What we have to remember is the one is here the problem is in cylindrical coordinate system. Okay. Apart from that, whatever the band they have given, the surface area they have mentioned, depending on that, you have to consider the differential surface area. Okay. Here, since the constant rho has been mentioned, what you have to consider is differential surface area for a constant rho. Okay. If so much has been defined, the further there is nothing much, just a substitution and doing a integration. We'll move on and take a new example. So second example is given J vector equal to 1 by r e power minus t ar cap. Okay. So find the current at r equal to 5 meter at t equal to 1 second, where current I is nothing but jr dot ds. So just a substitution, J is given into area, since it is as a circular loop, if you consider it is nothing but 4 pi r square, just a direct substitution. Okay. And part B is also given for a different radius and for the different time. So this is also the as a previous one, just a direct substitution we can compute. Okay. And the part C is find the volume charge density. Okay. Where volume charge density is minus dou by rho t of d rho v, which is nothing but divergence of J. So let us find out divergence of J. This is nothing but in spherical coordinate system. In spherical coordinate system, the divergence is 1 by r square dou by dou r of r square into that rho component. Okay, so we can substitute this rho component, differentiate, and then since you want to find out rho volume charge density, you have to, after doing differentiation, this dt you can cross multiply and then do the integration with respect to time t to find out the volume charge density. Okay. And after that, there is one more part here, find the charge density. Okay, charge density is nothing but current density divided by volume charge density. This is nothing but velocity. So it gives you so much r meter per second. Let me take the third example where the current density is equal to minus 10 power 6 z power 1.5 az cap ampere per meter square. Okay. And the rho is varying between 0 to 20 micrometer. Okay. And for rho greater than 20 micro, this J is 0. Now find the total current crossing z is constant here, where z equal to 0.1 meter in the az cap direction. Okay. Here the thing is, we have to take the differential surface area for a constant z. Okay. That is nothing but rho into d rho into d phi. Okay. So you are integrating this term with respect to d rho and d phi. Okay. Where z is constant. Okay. So there is nothing much z phi rho is varying between 0 to 20. And phi, they have not mentioned, let us take in general as a closed surface from 0 to 2 pi. So we can just integrate and substitute, this is nothing much. So once you get what is the differential surface area for a constant z, this is just a substitution and getting the value. So one more part in this, that is we have to find out if the charge velocity is so much at z equal to 0.1 meter, find the volume charge density, that is part B. Okay. So where the current density is nothing but rho v into velocity vector, we know this. Okay. So volume charge density can be written as J divided by velocity vector. Both has been mentioned, just do the direct substitution, we'll get the answer. Okay. And third part in the question is, if volume charge density is at z equal to 0.15 meter is minus 2000 coulomb per meter cube, find the charge velocity. Okay. So let us find out the charge velocity using the same equation, that is velocity can be written as J by rho v. So j is given, rho v has been mentioned in the problem in the part c. Just direct substitution will get the velocity vector. Okay. Now let us move on to something on we have come across now what is called current, okay, and the current density and the problem on that. Now we'll move on to the metallic conductors. Okay, so consider a conductor. Okay, what happens is in the conductor, you know, there will be a valence electron or the free electrons which will move in with the influence of electric field. Okay, so if you consider, because of the presence of electric field intensity, the force acting on these charges can be written as F vector equal to Q into E, or if I take the charge of the Q can be written as minus E, then we can write it as the force on this charge Q, which is equal to minus E, can be written as minus E into E field, okay, that is E vector. So force on the charge will be minus E into E vector. Okay, that is in the now what happens is in this so when you take it as a conductors, we will be having a crystalline material. Okay, so the charges will be continuously colliding with this lattice structure. Okay, because of this, the charges very soon it will attain a constant velocity, which will be called as drift velocity, and it is denoted by Vd vector. Okay, where the drift velocity Vd vector is can be written as minus mu e into E vector. What is mu e? Mu e is mobility of electrons in the given material. Okay, mobility of mu suffix e, mobility of electrons in the given material. So the drift velocity Vd vector will be equal to minus mu e into E field. Okay, then let me consider this as equation number 1. Now we know that current density can be written as rho v into velocity vector, but using equation 1, let us what will define it as current density. Let us write it as, instead of writing volume charge density into velocity vector, this velocity vector here, it is drift velocity, where we know what is drift velocity just now in the equation 1, it is minus mu e into E vector. Okay, so we can substitute here in the place of drift velocity, we substitute it as mu e into E vector. Okay, and instead of writing volume charge density, let me take it as the charge density of electrons. So the current density J vector can be written as minus rho e into mu e into E vector. Okay, there is one more thing. We know conductors will be having a conductivity which is denoted by sigma. Okay, so we know current density can be also represented, or it can be expressed as sigma into electric field intensity E vector. Okay, so J is equal to sigma into E vector. Consider this as equation number 3. Okay, so by comparing equation number 2 with this equation number 3, so here you have E vector with equal to E vector, this is nothing but conductivity sigma can be written as minus rho e into mu e. By comparing this and this, we can write conductivity equal to minus rho e into mu e. Okay, rho e is negative from this equation. Okay, where the current density J will be in the direction of E vector. Okay, what you can observe from this equation number 3 is the current density is in the direction of electric field intensity. Okay, so consider this conductor wherein it is having a surface area S, where the current I can be written as surface integral J dot ds, nothing but current density multiplied by the surface area. And the, if you apply the potential difference between this conductor at the ends of this conductor, then potential difference between the terminals A to B can be written as it is minus integral B to A E dot dl. Okay, it is nothing but the work done carrying a unit positive charge. So VAB can be written as minus integral this point to this point carrying the charge E dot dl. Or here, If I take this length of the conductor as L, we can write it as E dot L. Our potential V can be written as E into L. So we know current is nothing but J into S. Our current density is I by S, which is also current density can be written as sigma into E. Okay. Or in the previous equation, what we have seen is potential V can be written as E into L. Our electric field can be written as V by L. Okay. So we can substitute here in the place of electric field intensity as V by L. Okay. By looking at this third term and this term, I by S equal to sigma V by L. Okay. V can be written as, you can cross multiply. So it is IL divided by sigma S. Okay. So potential V can be written as L into I, where L is the length of the conductor. I is the current flowing over the conductor. Sigma is the conductivity of the conductor and S is the surface area of the conductor. Okay. So V can be expressed as L into I by sigma S. Okay. We know Ohm's law. From Ohm's law, V can be written as I into R. Okay. So hence, by comparing this V and this V, we can write the resistance R can be expressed as L by sigma S. Okay. R can be written as L divided by sigma S. Okay. R, you can also express the resistance R as the potential difference between the terminals AB, VAB, divided by current I, which will be equal to, the potential difference is nothing but this, and current I is nothing but this, where current I is nothing but J dot ds. What is J? J is nothing but sigma into E vector. So that is, in terms of writing J dot ds, it is written as here sigma into E. Okay. So R can be written as VAB by I in terms of electric field intensity. We can express in this manner. So knowing these expression with respect to conductors, we'll try to solve a few problems. Okay. The first one is find the magnitude of current density in a sample of silver for which conductivity is so much. Okay, and mobility of the electrons are so much. First thing is, we have to find out the drift velocity is given, okay, electric field intensity, and the sample of the cube with 2.55 meter and a side having voltage between opposite faces. Okay, we'll try to find out the magnitude of the current density for part A, part B, and so on. Okay, so what is part A? That is, we have to find out current density. You know, current density is sigma into E vector. R, you can write in terms of velocity, drift velocity vector, as minus mu into E. So using that, J can be written as sigma into velocity divided by mobility. Okay, which has been given in the problem. In the part A, velocity vector has been given here, the drift velocity is given, conductivity is given, mobility is given. Just a direct substitution, we'll get J vector equal to this 16.5. Okay. What is there in the part B? In the part B, the field is mentioned. We have to find out the current density, knowing rho, knowing mobility, and the knowing the field intensity, we have to find out the current. Okay. So where current is nothing but sigma into E, field has been mentioned, sigma is known, just substitute, we'll get the answer. Okay. What is part C? In the part C, the sample of cube with one side 2.5 mm is given, and the voltage applied is 0.4 millivolt. This has been given. We have to find out the current. So what is current can be written as sigma, current density is sigma V by L. So this, if you substitute, you will be getting it as current density. Okay. And next, current density for the part D is, the sample of cube is given and the side carrying current is given. Now you have to find out the current density. Okay. Where current density, there again it is I by S, current has been given, and the surface area, since they have given the side, it is surface area is nothing but side square. So if this side square, if you do, we'll get the current density. So by knowing the previous few relation, by doing direct substitution in this problem using those relation, we are finding the current density. Okay. I'll take one more problem, that is there is a copper conductor which has diameter of 0.6 inches and it is 1200 feet long, and the conductivity of the material is given and the current is 50 amps. Okay, first part of the question is find the total resistance of the conductor. We have to find out R. Okay, so what is R? R can be expressed as L divided by sigma into S. Okay, so in the problem the length has been given. Okay, 1200 feet long length is given. Okay, and the diameter is given, but this should be converted into radius. Only thing is it is not in the standard units, so this feet should be converted into meters, as well as this inches also should be converted into meters. Okay, so appropriate conversion has been done here by converting this, I mean converting here feet into meters. Okay, again here the surface area is nothing but pi into r square. So diameter was 0.6, so the radius is 0.3, and then the inches are converted into meters, so where the resistance we get it as 0.035 ohms. Okay, what is part B problem? The part B is find the current density. Okay, so what is current density? Current density is I by S. Okay, so current has been given in the problem, the same area pi into r square, so we get it as current density. Okay, so in the third one is what is the DC voltage between the conductor ends. Okay, potential difference we have to find out. So potential difference is nothing but L I by sigma S, R nothing but R into I. Already we have found this resistance, so resistance multiplied by the current. Using Ohm's law we get it the potential 1.75 volts. Okay, next, how much power is dissipated in the wire? Last part of the problem. Okay, what is the power? So power is nothing but VI. Okay, so just now we have got this V 1.75, and current is also there in the problem. Direct substitution V into I, we get it as 86.4 watts. Okay, R we can write it as I square R. Knowing I and resistance, using that also we can calculate. Okay, so power is VI R I square R. So let me take one more problem. The third problem, in cylindrical coordinates the J vector is given. Okay, 10 into e power minus 100 r into A5 cap ampere per meter square. Find the current crossing through the region r between 0.01 to 0.02, 0 less than z less than or equal to 1 meter, and intersection of this region with the phi with the constant plane. Okay, phi is constant. Okay, here again the problem is in, they have mentioned rho instead of rho, here they have denoted it as r. Okay, again the problem is in the cylindrical coordinate system. Okay, so in the cylindrical coordinate system the problem where generally the current I can be written as surface integral j dot ds vector. Okay, so here it is a constant phi, so differential surface area for a constant phi can be written as dr into dz a phi cap. Okay, so we have to recollect the differential surface area for a constant rho, constant phi, constant z, all those we have to remember. Okay, here the differential surface area for a constant rho, for a phi, it is dr into dz into a phi cap. Okay, because phi is constant, so constant phi is dr into dz into a phi cap. Okay, then what is this j dot ds vector can be written as? This multiplied by dot product with this differential surface area for a constant phi. Okay, so if you take the dot product, a phi dot a phi is 1. Okay, hence it becomes this, whatever this component, multiplied by this dr into dz. Okay, so we get it as this component, that is this question, multiplied by dr into dz. Okay, so this one, after doing the dot product, that is nothing but j dot ds. This should be integrated over a surface area with the varying r and z, so that we can find out the current I. So current I will be equal to surface integral, this differential, whatever the component we have got now, dr into dz. Okay, so r is varying from 0.01 to 0.02 given in the problem, and z is varying between 0 to 1. So let us take the limit z 0 to 1, and this is what the component. Okay, so let us take this, we'll integrate this with respect to r. Okay, so we have to integrate this with respect to r, and dz, integration of dz is nothing but z. Okay, and integration of exponential power minus 100 r will be e power minus 100 r divided by minus 100. Okay, so that is what the integration has been done here, integration with respect to r, and the limit has been substituted as 0.01 to 0.02. okay, so limit has been substituted, and z is limit is 0 to 1, so it will become 1 minus 0. Okay, so by substituting this limit, we get just this answer, that the current will be equal to 2.6 into 10 power minus 2 amperes. Okay, I'll take one more problem. Okay, the next problem is, find the total current in the outward direction from a cube of 1 meter with j equal to so much. Okay, that is, current I is nothing but surface integral of j dot ds, or it is also nothing but volume integral divergence of j dv. Okay, so we can find out the divergence of this. Okay, that is nothing but dou by dou x of jx plus dou by dou y of jy plus dou by dou z of jz. Okay, so you are differentiating this x component with respect to x, and y component with respect to y, and z component with respect to z. By doing that, we get the volume charge differential divergence of j as 4x plus 6xy square. Okay, so differentiating this with respect to x, we'll get it as 4x. 2xy cube with respect to y, differentiation, it will become 2y square into 2x. So it will become 2 into 3. So it will become 6xy square. Okay, and there is no z here, so differentiation of this with respect to z is 0. Okay, so we get only 4x plus 6xy square. Okay, so now the current is nothing but, instead of taking the surface integral j dot ds, we can also write it as volume integral, that is this volume integral divergence of j into dv. Okay, here the volume has been mentioned, so let us take the divergence of j into dv. Okay, so current I will be equal to volume integral of this. Okay, so where z is nothing but 0 to 1, y is all are varying between 0 to 1, and this is nothing but divergence of j. Now you are integrating this with respect to x, y, z. Okay, so each term should be integrated with respect to x, y, z, and then you have to substitute the limit. Okay, so first we are integrating with respect to x, substitute the limits, then integrate with respect to y, and then integrate with respect to z and substitute the limit, where the answer will be resulting it as 3. Okay, 2 plus 1, 3 into z, and z limit is 0 to 1, so we'll get the answer as 3. Okay, so it is nothing but current will be equal to 3 amperes. Okay, so similar problems are also there. Okay, current density can maybe there in the spherical coordinate system. I have taken an example in cylindrical and Cartesian coordinate system. There are similar problems are also there. Okay, spherical coordinate system and so on. Okay, So what we have done here is, in fact, we have come across the current and conductors, and we have expressed as a new term called current density. Okay. So further, we'll see in the next class on the boundary condition. Okay. I'll stop here. We'll look in the next class about boundary conditions. Okay. Thank you.